And Joel Ward, who came over from Nashville as an unrestricted free agent, cashes on the Knuble rebound.
The defending champions are out.
There are few things in this world that I can think of that's better than a Game 7 OT goal. Actually, there's one more thing I can think of. A Game 7 OT goal in the Stanley Cup Final. And yet, there's one thing might be better than that. A Game 7 OT goal in the Stanley Cup Final that your team or favorite player puts past the netminder. What a spectacular series we saw. Congratulations to the Washington Capitals. Congratulations to Alexander Ovechkin. Congratulations to Holtby. This was a spectacular series, three of which of these games went to overtime. All of these games were decided by one goal. This is a truly memorable series with an extremely interesting, fascinating, and exciting start to the first round of the Stanley Cup playoffs. Congratulations to Joel Ward for blasting the last shot past Tim Thomas and sending the Stanley Cup champions home. I have really enjoyed this series, and I hope you have too. That's basically all I have to say about that. Let's turn the page. I will remember that one for a long time.
What was the mood like in the dressing room coming out for overtime?
You know, we were excited. We killed a huge penalty. And that was, I thought that was a big momentum shift for us. Just, we got a little nervous there with 2.5 to go left in the period. And, to kill that, we felt confident. We were loose all day. And, we found a little confidence coming in this building as of late. And, we did it again tonight.
Braden Holtby's been a story the entire series. You haven't gotten a chance to probably know him very well. But what's his demeanor like around the team?
Oh, he's been unbelievable. He's been in a beast mode ever since he got here. And, hats off to him. He's carried the load for us. And, to play in a hostile environment, it's defending champs like this. And, he's calm and cool every day. He's got that swagger and that for us. And, we're just going to hopefully he takes us over to the next round.
Joel Ward scored the game-winning goal last night for the Washington Capitals in OT, pushing them to the second round of the Stanley Cup playoffs in a Game 7, no less. Nothing's better than that. Well, I hope he went out drinking and had a great time with his buddies last night. And I hope he didn't turn on his iPhone. And I hope he didn't check his Twitter account on his home computer, because if he did, he would have found out that he was attacked by a bunch of sore losing lowlifes fans on the Boston Bruins. See, Joel is Canadian, and his family apparently hails from Barbados, and his skin color is darker than a lot of hockey players. So, some lowlifes decided that would be a good reason to attack him after he made this great accomplishment. And this brings me to some of my favorite, well, maybe one of my favorite cities on Earth, Boston, Massachusetts. Now, I wouldn't want to paint everybody from Boston, or even Boston Bruins fans, and I certainly wouldn't want to paint the Boston Bruins themselves of having any kind of responsibility for this, but I got something to say. Boston sucks. You know what? Everybody from Italy that could cook probably moved to New York, because Boston pizza sucks. And you know what? I hope this is bigger than the curse in the Bambino. I hope that this is bigger than that stupid goat in Chicago. I hope your teams never win another championship again. Probably the most segregated state or city in the United States to get today. And then we got Matt Damon and Ben Affleck telling us how to live and how to think and how to feel with all these open-minded liberal universities that are in the Boston area. Well, you know what? Boston sucks, and I hope this lasts for a long time. I'm sick of Boston. I hope your teams never win another championship again. Curse! 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 Curse your teams! And congratulations to Joel Ward, and congratulations for knocking out the Stanley Cup champions, because they'll never win another one in my lifetime. Pray for forgiveness, Boston! Tonight. Big games. New Jersey Devils versus the Florida Panthers. New York Rangers versus the Ottawa Senators. I'm going to have a real problem making predictions because I don't know what's going to happen. Most of my predictions have been wrong, and I'm usually pretty good at this stuff. I think the game's changing. I think the physical play is making a lot more of an impact. And the fact of the matter is, nowadays, the idea is just get in the playoffs and do your damage there. It really doesn't matter if you finish first or you finish with the President's Trophy. Get in the playoffs, fight your way through. Both these games tonight. All right, here's my predictions. Both these games tonight will go to OT. That's pretty much it. I'm going to take the Devils over Panthers simply because I don't think the defense will hold up. I'm going to take the Rangers over Ottawa because I think Henrik Lundqvist is going to have a huge game. I can't give a score. I can't do anything else. All I can do is pray for my Rangers. And you know what? I might root for the Devils too because I'd like to see them in the later round. I think that would be entertaining. Maybe it's time for a 1994 rematch of epic proportions. And maybe, maybe Callahan behind the net. He swings it in front. He scores! Callahan. Yes, we Callahan, I do believe, but I'm quite nervous. Those are my predictions. Hey, that's all I got for today. Listen, there's two game sevens tonight. You have to see them if you're any kind of hockey fan. If you're not a hockey fan, this is a good time to give it a chance. It doesn't get any bigger than this. Should be a really big game. Thank you very much. For me, my video blog, Chopping Point, peace, we're out of here. Juice, I'll feed his aim. What else? Buonanotte? I don't know.
Ciao.
Ciao.